But you did a clinical trial, so, or you were involved in this clinical trial that you kind of mentioned, like, briefly, which I thought was very interesting, in it, the actual one with fasting, where the cancer patients fasted either before or after the chemo treatment. And I thought it was very interesting that you found, maybe you can talk about it, but you found that their normal cells were more resistant to the stresses of chemo, whereas the cancer cells were more sensitized to that.
Right, right. So, of course, all of this starts in mice, and in mice we were able to show very strong effects, what we call differential stress resistance, which is you protect the normal cells, but not the cancer cells, and then something called differential stress sensitization, where you kill the cancer cells, but not the normal cells.
Can you explain that a little bit, like why that is?
Yeah, well, that is, again, because the almost every organism, you can start with E. coli, actually, bacteria, and then move to simple organisms like yeast and all the way up to mice. They have starvation responses, right? So if you starve any system, virtually any system, they'll go into this shield mode, protective mode, and then they sit there until food comes around again. So in this protective mode, they're very resistant to all kinds of things. They're resistant probably because they have to be resistant to the sun and to chemical produced by other microorganisms that might be surrounding them. And so then they happen to also, at least mice and now we think humans, chemotherapy is also one of the toxins that they're resistant to. So you starve them, the normal cells go into the protective mode. When you starve a cancer cell, though, because the oncogenes are the regulatory genes of this protection, cancer cells, by definition, can never respond, right? So they're just normal cells respond no matter what normal cell it is, from a muscle cell to a hepatocytes to a brain cell, but the cancer cells don't respond. And that's really what's called differential stress resistance. In the differential stress sensitization instead, it really has to do with something that I think was underappreciated, which is a cancer cell is viewed as a smart cell. In fact, the cancer cell is a very dumb cell. And why is it dumb? Because it is evolved in all this high nourishment environment, right? So it's evolved with a lot of proteins, a lot of amino acids, a lot of sugars, a lot of growth factors. All these things are around all the time. So by making them available, I know that oncologists mean well, right? But by making all this available during chemotherapy, you're really helping one thing more than anything else, is the cancers, right?
What you're referring to is them telling people to eat a lot of calories.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, so they tell them. And so, you know, because the cancer loves sugar, it loves amino acids, right? And depends on sugar and amino acids. The more you give it, the happier it is. And also, these nutrients basically, you know, make the normal cells sensitive, right? So you're making the normal cells sensitive and you're making the cancer happy, right? Instead of the opposite, right, which is make the normal cells protected and make the cancer cells miserable. Why are the cancer cells miserable? Well, because again, having evolved in this abundance, once you take the abundance away, it's like almost saying, imagine somebody that had a very low IQ, you know, be looking for food, you know, and if you make it available, it's easy. Let's say, thinking about a monkey, that has got very low IQ, and you, you know, you put it in front of food all around it, and it's going to have no problem, right? As soon as you take the same monkey with a very low IQ and you make it extremely difficult to find the food, now that monkey is going to have a problem. And you know, and that's how we see the cancer cells. You know, once the amino acids are low, the growth factors and the sugar are low, the cancer is going to struggle. And then if on top of that you hit it with chemotherapy, it just has a very low chance of escaping. This is why in mice we see cancer-free survival, meaning that mice are free of cancer only when we combine the starvation or the fasting-mimicking diets with the chemotherapy. We almost never see it when we use each one alone, right? Mm-hmm. We and many other labs have tried that. You see, which is great, often the fasting or the fasting-mimicking diets are as good as chemo, but you never see the alone, each intervention alone being curative. So it's very interesting. And this is also very important to point out, because a lot of people tend to either be in the camp of traditional medicine or in the camp of alternative medicine. And people don't understand that, both of them are very important. And when you combine it, particularly the alternative integrative medicine that's got a deep scientific foundation, when you combine it, now you have a very powerful system, in your hands. And, whereas each alone doesn't work very well.